Hello, Malty. Meghan Markle. Can I start again, please? Thank you for your patience. Normal service will be resumed instantly. Hello, Malty Meghan Markle mothers, and thank you to NASA Crooks for that mention. I'm Ralphie. I'm in the Manx Bothy, in the middle of the Irish Sea, and for quite a long time, I've been asked for a tour of the Bothy. And seeing it's my 10th anniversary year, now is the time. I hope you enjoy the tour. There's not actually a lot to see, so it's going to be a slow tour. I've just finished reviewing an Oc 24 year old, a damn fine single malt to be honest, and this is Ralphy Review 765 Extras, just as your point of reference. Now here we go. I'll just score out the malt mention because now it's been mentioned. Right. How are we going to do that? I think we've just got to go over. Come around, climb over. I'm going to lift the camera and I'm going to take you on a little tour. It won't take long, to be honest, so bear with me. Just got to clear the clutter a little bit. Oh, here we go.
That's up.
Where will I start? Here we go. I'll start with a 360 degree turn. Right. At this point, you're going to see how small the Manx Bothy is. Okay. I'll come back shortly to show you the details. Because that's where the devil and the angels are. Oh, it's gone all dark. It's gone all dark because of the spotlight. Here we are. There it is. Look at that. There's the Bothy. Let's see if I can open the lens up a little bit. That's better. Let's finish the tour. The building's several hundred years old. It's a small servants' quarters Bothy, is part of a bigger house. So I don't actually live here. Here's the fireplace. And there is my newly installed stove. Luxuries. So is that when I'm recording my end of year Whiskey of the Year reviews, it's not quite as smoky. And this is, I've got to show you this, you're going to love this. This is the design for my badge, right? This is my 10 years Malt Mates badge, which will be on sale at selected whiskey shops throughout 2019. I've only got about 250 of these made, but this is how I modelled it. The bunnet, made with local tweed, and the bottle and the label. I changed the colour of the label, as you can see, just to make the badge a bit more visual. So this is the barrel, sawn off barrel to take it down a little bit, make it more comfortable and stable. And behind it, of course, you've got the shelf. I'll take you around the shelves, past the malt mention book. Me and my marks and things, a glass of whiskey. Here we are, Fanny and Bobby, with Eddie the Eagle behind, and a few Doctor Who references. I've finally got around to writing the candle, got the bottle of Daffmill to remind me I'm going to review one of the versions of Daffmill soon, and today's rain is tomorrow's whiskey. Isn't that lovely? I got that as a Christmas present. And this wasn't a Christmas present, but I'm fiercely proud of this. It's my 100,000 subscribers award from YouTube. Now we go down the shelf. There's the old, some of you remember this. Bring it out. It's the Triskelion, which is the emblem of the Isle of Man, with the Darlick next to it. Haggis, Iron Brew, usual trimmings, and along to the wee piper. And further down, this is the bit you don't see so much. This is the chalk there and basically my props. And below, I've got the more props that are going a little bit mouldy, the old malt marks. And then down at the bottom, oh, in the crypt, I've got old paint palette ralfy.coms. Moving round past the sword to the casks. Oh, now what the hell's going on here? I have to say, they're empty. They're there as props, and I'll tell you why. The finest place for me to be drinking whiskey is in a warehouse. Now, I don't have a warehouse, but I've recreated a warehouse in the Bothy, and it's just really, really nice. The smell's right, the atmosphere's right, it increases the coziness. What I have done is I've put some vodka into the casks to keep them sweet, to keep them wet. And that'll hang about. There's another old ralfy.com palette thing stuck there. And rather than a bung, I use these, granite eggs. They just sit over the top, over the Hessian, which is lubricated with Vaseline to form an airtight seal. And every now and again, I just top up these casks with some vodka to stop them drying out. Now, moving over a wee bit, down here, this is interesting. I've got, being my little temporary warehouse, I've got some gallon canisters. This is some Ardbeg 2010 that I've been immersing other woods in. So basically I got 6 bottles of Ardbeg 10-year-old, and then what I did was I put them into a gallon jar that winemakers use, and I've let it continue to glass mature rather than like the Armagnac does in France. And what I've done is I've just put in maybe some elmwood, ashwood, birchwood, whatever I feel is sympathetic but not too influential, and therefore I'm creating future versions of fairly unique single malt whiskies for my personal consumption. I might share some of it with you sometime, just tell you all about it. Moving round past my light, I've got this. It's the heater, just to heat the place and give a bit of a rosy glow to the atmosphere. It's my 10th anniversary balloons, which are now deflating, to be honest, because the helium's escaping. And here I've got small casks, some really old grubby bottles, a wee tribute picture of Pappy Popcorn sucking up in the wall. And there you go, you've got this little barrel in a barrel type thing. I mean, it explains, doesn't it, now why the walls are the way they are. This is the door. The door to the real world beyond. But we don't bother with that, do we? Because we're in the Bothy. The real world can wait. And what was I going to say? Yeah. No. Something. Righto. It was about the barrels. You see, I've remembered now. You see, the barrels having some vodka in them just to keep them sweet. I mean, I'll never use them for anything else. They're just a prop. I don't want them drying out and splitting and the wood shrinking and all the rest of it. But of course, there's alcohol in these casks, albeit it's just vodka, but that black coating in the wall is the fungi that feed off the alcohol in the atmosphere, and you'll see it with many distilleries around the world. That's what you get. And I've recreated it here. And the thing is that this isn't some lush, air-conditioned, neutral living room. This smells like a Dunnage warehouse. Essentially, it is a Dunnage warehouse. It does get cold and damp like a Dunnage warehouse. I mean, these floors, for example, you can see the dampness in the floor. I mean, that's just poured concrete. It isn't that many years ago that was actually just compacted earth. So here you have this reproduction with a few staves props, trimmings. Here we've got an old Haig box, John Haig's gold label, it says. And it just beautifully sets the scene. So I'll draw back and conclude with a nice far away view. There you are, elevated, of the studio. There you have it. I do hope you found this interesting. I'm Ralphie. I'm in the Bothy. I have now shown you the Bothy. And do you know what? Maltmates, I hope you've enjoyed your tour. See you soon. Bye-bye.